The Waddah Attar Explosion exploded onto the trading scene way back in 2006. I will show you how you can exploit its unique combination of the MACD and the Bollinger Bands to back some trend-following pips on the dollar-yen.
The WAE is not included in MT4 by default, but I've left the download link in the description. It consists of three parts: the histogram, the explosion line, and the dead zone line, each of which uses median prices. You can check out the source code to see how they are calculated, but if MQL isn't your cup of tea, let me help you. Each bar in the histogram is equal to the difference between the current and previous MACD value, multiplied by a sensitivity factor, which is set to 90 by default. If the current MACD is above the previous MACD, a green bar is plotted. If instead, the current MACD is below the previous MACD, this difference is multiplied by the negative of the sensitivity factor. Once again, we get a positive value, but a red bar is plotted. This is why the histogram values are always positive. Next is the explosion line, which is the difference between the current upper and lower Bollinger Bands. Finally, there's the dead zone line, equal to the 1.5 times the 14-period ATR. There are four common ways to use the WAE to generate entry signals. The idea is to trade in the direction of momentum while exploiting increasing volatility. For longs, the first possible condition is a rising green histogram, which indicates increasingly bullish momentum. You can use the number of consecutive rises to adjust the strictness of this entry. The next is to look for a rising explosion line, which serves as a volatility filter. Expanding Bollinger Bands indicate rising volatility, which usually accompanies strong trends. You can also look for the green histogram to be above the explosion line. Like the first condition, this serves as a momentum filter. And finally, check that both the green histogram and the explosion line are above the dead zone. Like its name implies, the dead zone filters out low volatility markets which don't work well for trend following. Must you use all four conditions together? Of course not. In fact, to minimize the risk of curve fitting, I recommend using only the important ones. All four conditions make sense, but I prefer not having any duplicate functions. The first and third conditions pick out strong momentum. However, I'm not a fan of the somewhat arbitrary comparison between the MACD differential and the standard deviation of prices. I'll stick to the histogram rising condition, which is the simpler of the two and works well enough for detecting momentum surges. The second and fourth conditions look at volatility. If you have a rising explosion line, there's a pretty good chance you're out of the dead zone too, so I'll dispense with the dead zone condition. I'll code the remaining two entry conditions into a custom strategy template. Here is the green histogram rising condition using the WAE's default parameters. I will require at least three consecutive rises. The rising explosion line condition is programmed similarly, except that I select the explosion line output. Supplementing these is a random condition. StrategyQuant's genetic algorithm will iterate through the millions of indicator combinations and automatically populate this placeholder with the best performing indicators. For trade management, in addition to my stop loss, I will select an optional bar-based time stop and profit target. Trailing stops usually work great for trend following, but I like to build strategies with a mix of exit methods, which tends to smoothen out the overall portfolio equity curve. I will now run the genetic algorithm using 10-year dollar-yen data, with half of it used for out-of-sample testing. Genetic evolution usually naturally results in some curve fitting, so be sure to include some subsequent robustness testing in your development. Here's one of the resulting strategies. The third entry condition is a close of the stochastic slow D line above 80. This confirms the bullish momentum detected by the WAE histogram. Buy stops are placed at the previous high, with a 98 bar time exit and a 4 ATR stop loss. Here's an example of a successful long and a short, where the stochastic has to close below 20. The equity curve shows only minor deterioration over the out-of-sample portion, giving these decent backtest statistics over the 10 years. If you want more backtested strategies, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. For an in-depth explanation on how StrategyQuant's genetic algorithm works, check out the video at the top right. To learn about robustness testing, check out the walk-forward optimization guide at the bottom.